Hello everybody, glad you could make it. My name is Kaylee Allen and welcome to another Repot with me / Q&A. Now, before I get into anything at all, this was gonna be a much bigger Repot, but due to unforeseen circumstances, I ran out of Aroid mix. I haven't been able to repot all the plants I want to. Coincidentally, I was gonna repot my Monstera Thai Constellation. I'll show you this really quickly because it's in the coolest pot in the world. See the roots on it? Look at the beast that is my Thai right there. She's actually poking out roots. You might be able to see, you probably can't. I can't really tip the pot, but there's a root here. There's another root coming out here as well. There's a couple of roots poking out basically. So she does need a bigger pot. I thought I had a pot big enough, but it turns out I don't. So I'm just gonna leave her, you know, as she is until I get a better pot. But the other thing I would like to repot, and I can repot, is this beautiful philodendron white knight that I hauled in my last video. So I'm quite excited to pot this. I do have enough mix for that. I just don't have enough mix for much else. This is basically the only mix that I have left, which is here. I don't have anything else left. I'm all out, so we've got to work with what we've got. So I did ask you guys on Instagram, as the last video, you know, last week's video went so well, I asked you guys, you know, ask me some questions and I'll answer them while I repot. So I'm going to get my little phone out. I'm going to look at your questions and probably just pick a mixture. I noticed I got some plant related questions, some, you know, me related questions. So I'll probably just try and mix it up as much as I can. So let's find your questions. First one, can you do a video about your aquarium, please? The answer to that is yes, I will. It's just, honestly, it's not ready yet. I'm still waiting for, you know, the tannin to settle and the bacterial bloom to go away. I'm still making sure I have enough fish in it because I think I have a 240 liter tank, which in American gallons, I think that's like a 60 or 62 gallon tank. It's reasonably big anyway, so I don't have much fish in at the minute. I'm looking over here because that's where the fish are. And the tank's kind of empty, so I'll probably wait till I get some more fish till the, you know, the tank settles down, everything looks nice. Maybe add some more plants because I'm looking now and there isn't really many. So we'll see how it goes. I do plan on doing a video, but it's just gonna be a little while, I guess. But it is in the pipeline, don't you worry about that. I probably will burn through a lot of questions, being that I'm only repotting one thing. So I will probably make it more question focused. Why don't you ship to the US? So this is a good one and I've been waiting to answer this, although I have kind of answered this on my website. So I will go into it. Basically, as you know, I started the rare plant shop with shipping to the US. My conditions were pay for the plant, pay for the shipping. If the plant does not make it through customs because I had no documentation, then I will refund you the cost of the plant minus the shipping, which I know a few of you have experienced. That's all well and good. You know, I refunded the shipping, everything was good. So when plants used to be caught at customs, what would happen is they would actually just be destroyed. They wouldn't come back to you. So I was kind of surprised to get the plants back. That was my first kind of indication that something wasn't quite right. But nonetheless, I got, you know, a lot of the plants back that were stopped at customs. What I didn't know was that UPS charge an unbelievable sum of money to return the plant to you if it's lost as customs. So basically, not only was I refunding the customer, you guys, I was getting back the plant. I mean, it was obviously not in great shape because it had done twice the journey and it was summer. Not only did that happen, but I also had to pay again for the fee of returning the package to me. And they were hefty fees, guys. They were hefty. So I just had to promptly close shipping to the US until I got the documentation sorted. The documentation was supposed to be sorted very quickly anyway. And you know, that didn't go as planned. So for now, I've ceased shipping to the US. Those are my reasons. I would go out of business if I continued. And I do aim to obviously have shipping to the US available by next year. So I am working on that. That is still a thing. Just consider the whole US situation kind of paused for now. But of course, I will keep you updated on that as soon as I find out more info and as soon as the photo comes online. Are you going to the International Aroid Show in Florida? Yes, I am. I'm leaving in, I think, round about 2 weeks and I'm very, very, very excited. This is like Christmas come early for me. So I'm super, super excited to be going there. Hopefully meeting a lot of new people, seeing all the plants. I'm quite excited to go to America anyway because I've never been to America. So that's like super exciting for me. So genuinely, very excited over here.
Oh, I like this one. Who do you like to watch and get excited by on YouTube?
Okay, so if it's not plant stuff, because we all know who the top plant YouTubers are that we usually watch, it depends what I watch. I watch according to what I'm kind of into at the time, or if I don't have a lot of time, which I usually don't, I'm only really looking for very specific things. So it's going to be very specific, if that makes any sense. Like, if it's makeup related stuff, I usually watch one YouTuber in particular. I don't necessarily watch the huge beauty gurus because I'm just not about that life. I do watch Kathleen Lights. She is possibly the best beauty YouTuber, in my opinion. I mean, have you seen that girl's skin? Like, how do you do that? What witchcraft is at work to get skin like that? I don't even understand it myself, but I really want to know. If it's not that, at the minute, I'm quite excited by the whole fish thing. So I've been watching a few different fish YouTubers. I'm not ashamed to say it. I've spent a lot of time looking into fish, both educational stuff and just the fun stuff, really. I think I watch, is it Coralfish 12G and the King of DIY? That guy is insane. He built like an entire like section on the side of his house where he just has fish tanks. It's the coolest thing ever. I love it. I love it so much. Other than that, I don't watch YouTube that much. I know that sounds like insane, but I don't have much time. I work so much. I do obviously watch the odd drama channel. Not in particular, I just kind of, if there's tea that's recommended on my feed, you know, I will be keeping hydrated, shall we say. You know, the whole Jaclyn Hill thing, that was memorable, wasn't it? That was like a whole month of that fiasco. So yeah, it just depends, but it depends what mood I'm in, it depends what I'm looking for, because 9 times out of 10, I'm looking for something on YouTube when I watch stuff. Well, I like this one. Where's the most unusual place you have found a plant? Now, the place itself isn't unusual, but the type of plant I found there was, to me, very unusual. So I was actually at Edinburgh Zoo. When was this? Ooh, 4 or 5 months ago, maybe. And it was the koala enclosure. I went there, I was looking at the koala. Don't get me wrong, koala was very beautiful. It was hugging the tree. It was fast asleep. It had a little baby. It was the best thing ever. But I noticed out of the corner of my eye, a monstera. Right? It was sat in like the corner of the enclosure, like almost like growing out of like the crack in the wall. And it was variegated. It was an Albo borzagiana essentially, but clearly, I mean, they wouldn't have planted that there because it was just among, you know, other wild growth. It was clearly just a natural mutation. But there was a variegated monstera just sat in the koala enclosure. Yeah, if you've been to Edinburgh Zoo up north and you've seen that variegated monstera, please write in the comments below if it's still there. Because everyone's just sat there looking at this beautiful koala and I'm just like, snip, snip. There's a lot of questions here, guys, about like my favorite plant. Because there's so many questions, I might just do a full-on video on it. I think it might be easier. So I'm not gonna answer those questions now. I'll just do it in another video another time. I think that's probably easier because I can really go into detail about why I like them and all the rest. I can't really do that here. And then I'll get to show you the plants as well. So I will do that in a separate video. I think it's probably the best way of doing it. What is your favorite and least favorite thing about doing YouTube? The favorite thing about doing YouTube is 100% getting to talk to you guys and meet new people and share generally the love of plants, share my knowledge of what I know. I'm not the most knowledgeable person in the world, but I like to think that I help people and give them, you know, advice and just generally share what I know with people. That's definitely the most fun thing. The least fun thing is the fact that, and I guess maybe other YouTubers might relate to this, you really can't please everybody. Like, if you do a video where people want to get to know you more, there'll be a percentage of people that think that you talk too much and they don't want to hear about it, they're just here for the plants. But then if you go down that route, then people are like, well, you've got no personality and people don't know you, and then they feel distance towards you. So in some senses, feeling like you can't please everybody, it's not something that you guys are doing wrong, it's just a frustration, really, and it's just something that you kind of have to learn to just accept. But that's probably one of the things I don't love so much about YouTube. It's just being able to communicate with people in the way that you want to be received is quite a struggle, actually, week to week. That, I find that quite difficult, to be honest. What do you think is the strangest thing that Americans say or do? There's only one that, like, you know, comes to mind immediately, and that is a word that you guys use, and I think it is the word for your butt, and that is the word fanny. So you hear people saying fanny, and I'm laughing because, you know, I'm a 12-year-old boy inside, but that's not what it means here, okay? Don't mean that here. It means something a little bit different. That's the only thing I can think of, like, off the top of my head. And I just think, yeah, that's weird. Don't say that. Please don't say that. We're in public, you know? How much do you think your entire plant collection is currently worth? I don't even want to calculate that. That's terrifying. Like, I have a somber face because that's actually terrifying, because when I look after these plants, I don't think necessarily of that. I think of that if something goes wrong, you know, if something's yellowing or something's wilting, I'm like, oh my God. But most of the time I don't think of them that way. So to have to think about them that way, oh God, I don't know. I mean, it's in four figures. Some plants I have alone are four figures. So I don't know. I don't even want to guess. I don't even want to know. La 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 la. What kind of plant you absolutely dislike? I am really, really, really sorry to all of you succulent lovers out there, but I just don't get it. It's not for me. I don't know, maybe it's just because I like to baby my plants to death, so I'm big on the watering and maybe I just kill them. But generally, like, I'm a foliage girl. Like, this to me is beautiful. I'm not saying, you know, succulents aren't beautiful. They just aren't for me. I cannot see myself ever owning a succulent. It's not my vibe, you know? You feel me? Guys, there are so many questions. Like, I have no hope of even denting them. My goodness. You have a Spiritus Sancti? Yes. If you don't know already, that's in my last week's video, so go check that out. Yes, I do. I have two. One is kind of doing better than another, admittedly. One is a bit of a stump. One is a little bit more of a full plant, but they are still juvenile, so. But I do have them, yeah. I'll answer one more question because it actually took zero time at all to repot this. So all I have to do is put it in its little decorative pot right here. So I'll answer one more question and I'll just kind of pick one at random. Da, 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 da. Question about plants on my wish list. Again, I will probably just wait till next year and then formulate a new wish list because we're getting to close of season now. So I'll probably do my homework over the winter and, you know, sit there over Christmas and figure out what I want for next year. So I'm not going to do that now either. Plus, I don't actually think I've got anything on my wish list right now. So we'll skip that one. Why do you think the monsteras have become so popular? I don't know if you mean variegated monstera, but I'm going to assume that you do. I think, honestly, they look really beautiful, whether it's this one or the albo in the back there. They look very beautiful. They are all over Instagram. They're very easy to propagate, and honestly, they're very hardy. They're almost as hardy as just a regular monstera. So I think for that reason, a lot of people go and get those plants because they're really, really beautiful. You know, got nice variegation on them. They grow of size, so they can really occupy a nice area, or you can just keep them small and, you know, keep cutting them down. You can technically make a very small earning off them by selling off a leaf every now and again. I think they're just a good all-round plant to have if you want a variegated monstera. That goes for Thai Constellation and the albo, Borsigiana, but I think that the Thai is not quite as popular as the albo. I still think the albo is like the number one thing. Everybody messages my shop and asks for albo cuttings all of the time. So I think it's just popular for those reasons. It's hardy, it looks beautiful, it's everywhere. It's not the hardest thing to get a hold of, like, it's not super rare, but it's in such high demand that you can't get it, if that makes sense. So it's not super rare, but just everywhere sells out straight away, and cuttings are pretty much like gold dust. So I think that's why they're so, you know, popular and sought after. Well, this is a kind of failed repotting because that took me no time to repot this plant, but never mind, I've answered some questions. So at least, you know, we were productive in some sense. This is my gorgeous philodendron white knight. I would normally pot this up into one of my dark grey pots with the saucers, but I really didn't bother. Because it's white and it's beautiful, I really wanted to emphasise the white. So for once ever, I've actually put it in a regular nursery pot and into this plant pot. So I will show you up close, although you will have seen this last week, but it's just, oh, it's so pretty. Ooh, I hope I get more leaves like this. This is just giving me life, I'm not gonna lie. So that completes this video. Thank you very much for sending me in your questions. There were a lot of questions here. There were just insane amounts of questions. I've addressed, you know, I picked a few to address. Some of them are kind of worth more of a video on them, so I deliberately haven't answered them. So I probably will prepare videos on a lot of the things that you guys have asked about in due course. I don't know when that'll be, but no doubt I will do videos on those things. Until then, thank you very much for watching this video. Have a fantastic weekend. If you're doing any repotting or anything special with family or friends, then I hope you have a great one. And I will see you very soon. Bye, guys!